This video is to provide some information to help answer some of the questions that people often ask about the Jubilee Flood Relief Channel. I hope it helps everyone to understand more about how the Jubilee works when we operate it. Before we look at the Jubilee Flood Relief Channel, we are going to take a step back and look at what happens to cause flooding in the River Thames. Every flood is different. How and when flooding occurs depends on many different factors, such as when and where rain falls and how saturated the ground is. As an example of how the River Thames can respond to prolonged and heavy rainfall, we are going to look at what happened in the lead-up to January 2024. With the early storms, some water would seep into the ground. As we had more rain, the ground gradually became saturated. That means that there is no more space in the soil for water. Instead, water then runs over ground and into rivers and streams. At first, water flows into the tributaries of the River Thames. The extra water flows down the tributaries, in some cases spilling out of the riverbanks and flowing across the floodplain. As it does this, low-lying land, including farms, roads, and sometimes properties, can experience flooding. In January 2024, ice slip on the River Ray was one of the first areas to experience the impacts of flooding. We began operating the Jubilee Flood Relief Channel at this stage because the flow in the River Thames was already high. As levels on the River Thames increased, we made regular gate movements in line with our operating procedures. Floodwater made its way from the tributaries into the River Thames. As water moved downstream, further communities were affected, including Oxford, Abingdon, Reading, Henley, Marlow, Raisbury and Staines. The Environment Agency sent out flood warnings to those signed up to receive them to let people know that flooding is expected and to take appropriate action. The increase in river levels during the January 2024 flooding was similar both upstream and downstream of the Jubilee Flood Relief Channel. Areas flooded because of the long series of storms followed by intense rainfall falling on saturated ground. Let's think about what happens to the flow on the Thames, both with and without the Jubilee Flood Relief Channel in place. To do this, we need to understand what we mean by flow. Imagine standing on the bank of a river. The flow is the amount of water that is going past you every second. As flow increases, so does the depth of water. This means you may see the water moving faster and the water level rising. A good way to look at this is to show a graph if we have time and days along the bottom, and then think about how the flow in the River Thames would be without the Jubilee Flood Relief Channel. When we split some water from the Thames so that it flows down the Jubilee rather than across the floodplain, the presence of the Jubilee River means that the floodplain will fill up at a later stage if the Jubilee reaches its maximum flow. Water travels through the Jubilee more efficiently than it would if it was naturally flowing through the floodplain. Because of these two factors during the early stages of a flood, whilst water levels are rising, the water gets to the areas downstream of the Jubilee slightly earlier than it would if the channel wasn't there. This graph is showing the flow on the River Thames for a location downstream of the Jubilee Flood Relief Channel. The orange line shows how the levels in the Thames increase slightly more quickly with the Jubilee there than without it. This is only about 2 to 4 hours earlier. By the time you reach maximum levels in the Thames, there is no difference in flows with or without the Jubilee Flood Relief Channel. Sometimes the levels can fall faster with the Jubilee in place. The length of time water remains high for can vary with each flood, but it's often for a few days, with the whole flood lasting much longer. Some key points to remember. The Maidenhead, Windsor and Eton Flood Alleviation Scheme, which includes the Jubilee Flood Relief Channel, is designed and operated to ensure that it does not make flooding worse for properties downstream. The scheme was designed to reduce the risk of flooding to approximately 3,000 properties in Maidenhead, Windsor and Eton. It is not designed to reduce flood risk to communities upstream or downstream of the scheme. It does not adversely impact property downstream, as verified by an independent report. As river levels start to rise on the River Thames, water does arrive slightly earlier downstream with the Jubilee in place. This is because water moves slightly faster through the Jubilee than it would through the floodplain. However, it does not lead to increased flooding to properties, as verified by an independent report. Our flood warning service takes account of this by making allowance for it in the way our duty officers issue flood alerts and warnings. People have the same amount of time to prepare for flooding because our warning and informing service accommodates any adjustment. So please make sure you are signed up to flood warnings and know what to do if flooding is expected.